And we are back. Thank you for joining us for the interview portion of this Tuesday, the 31st of July, 2012 edition of Teleprompter Free News. We're going to have for close to an hour with us Fritz Springmeier, author, researcher here in studio, former political prisoner. He wrote, amongst many other books, Bloodlines of the Illuminati, which is the first place I read a lot of things that are now admitted. But when I read this 15 years ago, I thought it was, well, a lot of it was wild. Some of it I already knew from my own research, but a lot of it was just over the top. And then over the years, so much of it has turned out to be true. I found none of it that I could prove wrong. And I wish that wasn't the case because I mean, look how it turned out that, of course, Sandusky was raping kids in broad daylight, you know, in the middle of the day in the showers. And, of course, it turned out the entire leadership knew, and the local word is, it's on the local news, they were selling the kids to all these elitists. That's what comes out of the Catholic Church now with all that infiltration. It's what's going on in Congress. They just hired the head of Penn State, who was caught covering up, to work for Homeland Security in a super secret position. We don't get to know. You know, that's where these sickos go now, is just to higher and higher levels of power. But if you study history, every ancient culture sacrificed human beings and tortured them and did other rituals. And in every culture, sickos gravitated to power positions and demanded firstborn be sacrificed, whether it was the Mayans or the Druids in Europe, or whether it was Central Asia, what's Pakistan today, or the Middle East. Every culture does this. And when you know anthropology and sociology and elite psychology throughout history, then you read a book like this and you understand Bloodlines, the Illuminati, and how real this is. I'm not saying I have all the answers. I'm not saying Fritz is right about everything. We're looking for the truth, though. That's the difference. We all wear rose-colored glasses, but we're looking for the truth. We're not trying to put out disinformation like the corporatist media. So I got a host of issues I want to cover with Fritz, who's here in town. He's visiting his father, who lives nearby Austin, San Antonio, to be exact. And so it's a rare in-studio visit with Fritz Springmeier. And I want to go over, just starting off, the Aurora shooting of a few weeks ago and whether he thinks that has any telltale signs of being staged. And then I want to look at his awakening, his path, in an abbreviated breakdown of how you woke up, what you witnessed, how you discovered the Illuminati. Because we got some of your books here that are out of print that I hope to get back into print. The Illuminati formula used to create an undetectable mind control slave. We're going to go over some of this book, show some of the exhibits here on air. And another one of his books that's out of print, this was out of print, Bloodlines was, but we reprinted it, Deeper Insights into Illuminati Formula, Part 1, how the Control Comes About by Fritz Springmeier, Part 2, How the Help Comes About with Cisco Wheeler. And so, again, he joins us here today to break this down. Then I have a few news articles I want to mention to him later. Okay, Fritz, good to have you here in studio, my friend.
Thank you. It's a privilege.
It's a privilege to have you here. Tell us about, actually, let's get into your awakening first and the short course and how you woke up to mind control. Then let's get into the current events and then back in to the deeper areas of mind control. But tell us about Fritz Springmeier.
Okay. All of us have heard the term mind control, but I was totally unaware of the Illuminati's mind control, which is like a million times more powerful than what we think of when we think of mind control. I started working with people that were trying to escape the Illuminati, and at that point, my learning curve improved drastically because I started realizing the things that were keeping them from escaping, and one of the big things was the mind control. If they tried to talk about what they had been involved with, suicide programming would kick in, and so I had to deal with suicide programming, like the woman that helped me with this Deeper Insights. As we would be going through deprogramming, I would sometimes be dealing with like six or more suicide programmings going off. She'd be wanting to slash herself. She would want be grabbing drugs, and I'd be having to take them out of her hand, and on and on. And so I had to watch every second to make sure that she didn't self-destruct. I got on-the-job training, and I got to see the handlers, the programmers, and all these people come around, try to interfere in her life. It was totally amazing. And so I guess you could say I was learning in the school of hard knocks. And at a certain point, I felt like I knew enough and had gotten to the point where I could expose what was going on. And I tried to, I had like 150 files of different things that were being done in the mind control. And I knew that was way too much. And I boiled it down to 12 sciences and came out with this book so that people could realize how the formula is constructed. The mind control is not one item. What makes it so powerful is that they're taking every known technique of controlling a person and they're putting it into a recipe, a group package that's very sophisticatedly engineered.
Full spectrum.
Yeah, exactly. So, you know, as kids, we used to do a real simple type of mind control. We'd grab someone's arm and twist it behind their back and say, say uncle, you know. Well, they also use physical threats against people. And if you start to think about each one of these types of mind control, in themselves, they're almost sufficient to control a person. But if you add them together in a sophisticated package, that group package locks the person in. And not only that, but they have these people blackmailed. They sometimes set them up with great careers. Maybe they're a judge, but they've come in, and like Cisco would tell me, she would tell me how she was used as like a 10-year-old. She would go into a judge who would enjoy this pedophilia experience, and then she would have a part of her mind, which is called an altar, that was programmed to go comatose. So in the middle of him slapping her around, she would go comatose. He would think that she had died, that he had murdered this little child that he was sexually abusing. And then, of course, the Illuminati come in and say, well, we'll take care of this. Well, no problem. We'll take care of this so you don't get into trouble. But all the time, they're taking all the evidence and everything, and that's put in a file. I had a friend who actually saw all of the files for his state that showed that everybody who was of any significance and had any power, they had the goods on that person, that if they didn't toe the line, they could send them to prison. So even if the person that you know that is in government has a good heart, they know that they have to toe the line if they don't want to be taken down. And sometimes some of these characters that we see in the media that they decide to go after, they've stepped over the line somewhere and now they're going down and they have the power to do it.
Sure. And the system also promotes their compromised minions and then gets them to run for office. And then the occasional person that gets in who they don't control, they just try to demonize.
Right. Exactly. Or they just ignore. If you're not, for years, I was putting out this important information, and I was totally ignored. You know, I mean, mainstream media never interviewed me. now, thanks to you and your show, I'm getting some exposure. But for many years, I was just a quiet mouse in the corner.
When do they really start coming after you? I mean, do you know what buttons it was that you pushed or what tripwires you hit?
I started writing and exposing them in 1990. And what happened was they started surrounding me with a lot of people that pretended to be my friends but weren't, were working for them. And they were sizing me up. They were sizing up where my weak points were, what my routines, how I thought. And then in 95, so it took them about 4 years, in 95, everything just came down on me. And I believe I was divinely protected, and I came out through that at the end of 95, still intact and still able to stand on my feet, so to speak. And then the next time I really got slam dunk was in 2001. When they raided my place, which felt like a full military operation, helicopters, the helicopters chased the horses in my pasture so that they ran through the barbed wire fence and had to be sewed up the next day by the vet. They had snipers in the woods. They had, it was a full-blown military operation when they raided my place. And from then on, just a matter of time before they were able to incarcerate me. And of course, you know the rest of the story.
Well, Fritz, continuing along the line of all this, you know, we don't just talk about, you know, Pedophile Valley there in Pennsylvania and that whole operation with kids or Boys Town or any of this or the UN. You just type in UN child sex slaves. There's thousands of articles. They're always doing it. And they go diplomatic immunity.
Right.
This is a guild. This is a group that gets into power so they can operate and get away with it. And it even came out that the Texas Youth Commission, with all the kids they've grabbed, the CPS, you name it, were using them as child sex slave brothels, and the Texas Rangers tried to stop them, and they were blocked. And the head of the DPS was removed. So even when the state police tried to stop it, it was no. And that was exactly what came out in the news, but only the back of the paper, was it was judges and the local government people. They were the ones going to the youth commissions to rape the children. And then, I mean, and you realize, my God, there's these, who are these people? I guess you could call them the Illuminati.
Well, not all of them necessarily are part of the Illuminati, but they're definitely part of the network. They're going along with the system, and they've gone beyond. At first, they were just using this trauma-based mind control on their own people, but they've now expanded it. It's being used on the general population.
That was my next question. I have it right here. Mass mind control. Mm-hmm. You're talking about suicide record in the military. It's like 6-7 times any previous record. Death education, which they prove teaches kids how to commit suicide, so that number goes up. The psychotropics cause suicide. Then there's more suicide, there's more psychotropics. I mean, this is quite a plan they've created, but they admit people go into a dream state when they go into suspended disbelief. I go to a movie now, never suspend disbelief. It's like childlike watching the public watch these movies. Other people, though, TV, anything, they're in a dream state. Describe the language is being reduced. People's brainwaves are being lowered. Break down the mass mind control, how that's working.
Well, the television is a very effective vehicle, and Anton LaVey said that was a satanic altar to bring Satanism to the general population.
They assault you through it.
Yeah, yeah, and he's right. It's most amazing. I've sat there and watched Christians. They're not even critically thinking. They put in these Walt Disney movies that are just a cult from start to finish, and then feel like they're giving their children something decent. Even watching the Olympics, you know. And I'm not trying to say this to criticize anything. I'm just making, raising people's awareness. This Olympics that we have going on, the first song that they played, that the orchestra played, was Nimrod. Who is Nimrod? And these people, the Rothschilds that I write about in there, they trace their genealogy back to Nimrod. Who was Nimrod? And why do we celebrate Christmas when we celebrate it? And
let me ask you the question.
All questions people should be asking.
Since you bring up the Olympics, for those that didn't watch it, I watched the opening ceremony, like 2 hours of it. It was nauseating because I was fully conscious watching it. Flashing pyramids, all-seeing eyes, eyes on fire, men humping each other, but at split second, I'm like telling my family, do you see this? They're like, no, what are you seeing? I'm like, well, you're relaxed. Wake up. Right. Women kissing, and the media even covered it later, but they would flash. Women, this is little kids are watching this. Women kissing, men humping, pyramids, demons rising, feeding on children in hospital beds. Three different audios at once to overwhelm the conscious mind. Explain what's happening there, because it's, I mean, it's overt mind control. But like you said, it was what you said. It was total fusion. After about an hour and a half, had to go out of the room, and I kept coming back, and I said, that's it, let's turn it off. I was becoming physically ill because it was just this banging and clanging, and my mom's like, why is it so horrible? Why is it? And I was like, that's the point. And then after two or three horrible songs, they would play something cute like Chariots of Fire with a goofy guy jogging, and that was the rest and the torture, and then it would come back in.
Exactly. And what you have is several levels of things happening. One is you have your generalized mass mind control, where they're making the general population dissociative and planting things in. But then there's a deeper thing where these people here that are under the Illuminati's total mind control, they're embedding triggers, they're embedding programming symbols and stuff in there, also in that kind of stuff. And also, they use watershed events like Princess Di or 9/11. They use watershed events in these people's mind control time clocks. They've got an internal time clock because they're all programmed to do some little part in this whole big long script. And those are controlled by major events. So there's no way that the mind control victim is not going to hear about, like, the shooting that just happened. And that shooting that just happened in Denver is going to then cause his little internal clock to turn a little bit, so that at a certain point, now he's going to do his little part in this big script that they have. It's very orchestrated. You know, we talk about, they say, well, it wasn't time for this invention. As I was working with the deprogramming of people, I was shocked to discover they were actually programming inventions into people, programming this person over here to accidentally meet this person, and then synergistically all of this scripted thing, and it looks like...
That sounds crazy, but they admit this. They're into playing God. Why do they, I mean, I have my ideas about it because I've studied classic black magic that they follow, so I understand them. They believe in lesser magic. You have to build the model of it, burn a ship before you really burn it a month later, kill an effigy of a child before you really do it. They believe that magnifies the power hundreds of times, so that's why they always tell us in movies and TV exactly what they're going to do, like 9/11. They had shows where the government flies a plane into the building to have martial law to attack Afghanistan. They use a drill to make it stand down. But it can also be an open threat to other governments. Hey, see, we really did this. Explain why they always have to tell you what they're going to do.
Well, you did a good job right there. And another reason is these people that are trapped in the mind control, if they do want to break free, they're just told, look, we showed them exactly what we were going to do, and did anybody do anything about it? I mean, you think that you're going to escape from us when our symbol is on the back of every dollar bill? You know, you walk into every federal building and there's our symbol?
So it's gang tagging. Yeah, you're saying, yeah. I mean, it's like this is our, you know, Sauron symbols, the all-seeing eye. Yeah. We're in control. Right. You figure that out yet? We'll do what we want.
Right. We'll even show them what we're going to do, and they're not going to do anything. And you can't run from us. We're everywhere. We're the all-seeing eye. You know, they like you say, they're wanting to play God. They want their little slaves to think that they're omniscient, omnipotent. Of course, we know that there is a God, and he's much bigger than them, and they can think that they're God, but they're not.
Well, yeah, because they're following a dark force, but also they're still just people. They're trying to control everything, but they're not in control of themselves.
True. And just the mere fact that you and I are still here and operating is proof that there is a God.
I agree with you. We certainly get persecuted. I haven't been persecuted like you have, and I don't need to be tested like Job. I know all good things are from God. I don't think they're coming from me, but I tell you, it is just fantastical to see how much stuff we thought was conspiracy and we weren't sure about is now just out in the open. Why is everything coming so out in the open now?
Well, there was a book that Alice Bailey wrote, Externalization of the Hierarchy, and she explained that that's what the Illuminati hierarchy wanted to do. They wanted to take what they were doing in secret, and they wanted to turn it over and put it to the public arena. And so now we see all of these Illuminati hand signs. We see all of these occult symbols that become popular. And that's what they wanted to do. She said that they're going to create a world religion. Basically, it's a witchcraft religion. And you'll notice that you can go to all kinds of stores, your fast food places, and so forth, and they will promote witchcraft on their bags that they give you the hamburger in, or their placemats or the toys that they sell. But if someone were to try to, like if you went to Wendy's and they put Christ on the bag that they gave you the hamburger in, people would protest. And yet they can promote witchcraft, and it's acceptable. It's quite amazing the extent that they have conditioned the public.
And then they've got all these well-meaning people that go, oh, I'm into white witchcraft. They don't understand the roots of it. Go to the roots of the Illuminati religion, because when I interrupted you, we're getting into the opening thing being Nimrod, the beginning of their great work, and the Rothschilds, you know, tracing themselves back to Nimrod, and they say that. And of course, then I think they're Merovingians too, back to Christ and all this. You know, the child with Mary Magdalene they claim happened. You know, the Holy Grail type business. Who do they really think they are? Who are the Illuminati? And if they have their way, what is the world they're going to build?
Well, the members that I was working with would tell me that at the high-level meetings, they were actually receiving instructions from Satan. And Christians can accept that, but non-Christians might find that startling. I'm just sharing with the audience what I was told. They would describe these encounters and what would happen. And if we think of what the Bible says about Satan, is that he had been given as a cherub this planet, and then God kind of ignored him in a sense by turning over dominion of this planet to humankind. And he told Adam and Eve, he said, you know, you are to take care of this. This is a garden. You're to, you know, I'm giving you dominion over things. And so we see this incredible jealousy which translates into the desire to destroy the human race. And when I look at their agenda, it doesn't look to me like a human agenda. It looks like, whether you want to call them evil aliens or demonic or whatever, this agenda is for the destruction of the human race.
And our DNA is being fried.
Exactly.
The sperm counts. I mean, they're killing us. We're in deep trouble.
Yeah, it's genocide.
No flesh would be left if God doesn't intervene.
Exactly. It's a genocidal. That's one reason why I'm standing up and doing what I have been doing, is because I'm just one little insignificant person. But their agenda is horrific. And so when you see the magnitude of what of the evil that they have planned, and like you've been talking about, the pedophilia and abuse of the children and the white slavery and so forth, how can a person not stand up and say, hey, enough is enough?
And notice how they're openly saying, yeah, we kill people. Yeah, we torture people. Yeah, we do sexual things to them in the torture. HBO recently puts on shows during the family hour showing four-year-old girls doing things I can't say on air. But it's okay for them to do it. They could just bombard during the Olympics. I mean, there is this, it's not about tolerance. It's not about freedom. They want to hurt people. They want to destroy innocence. Everything I read about the devil, that's them.
Yeah.
So even if the devil doesn't exist, as some atheists believe, whatever, it's manifesting through these people.
Yes. And then the good, nice front cover for Satan is Lucifer. Lucifer is said to be the light bearer. And then an even better front cover for Lucifer is Prometheus. And I'm surprised that they haven't promoted Prometheus before now. They've just recently come out with a film, Prometheus.
We're seeing a lot of Prometheus iconography.
Yeah. Because that's the good front for Lucifer.
Yeah, he's the guy that gives fire to the humans.
Who gives knowledge and wisdom. Right. He's defying the gods.
But the devil always seeks to actually control and dumb down. So explain that riddle of the Bible that Lucifer wants to give us knowledge.
Well, he really doesn't. As you know, we're paid in counterfeit. He pays in counterfeit.
Everything's a fraud. It's a twisted knowledge.
Exactly. Like you were saying earlier on your show, what's right is now seen as wrong, and what was wrong is now right. Everything's upside down. So all this great wisdom and knowledge that they have is really dung. You know,
because man had the perfect knowledge of being with the Creator and in God's creation and being good and pure. The knowledge of good and evil was evil hadn't even entered the equation. So the twisted knowledge or the virus was
exactly
injected. That's yeah.
Exactly. So we're so These people are not bringing us enlightenment. They're bringing destruction. And they promise freedom, but they're actually giving slavery. It's just like the toys you have out there, I saw, you know, that they're selling in the stores. Peacekeepers. And they're soldiers, you know.
Well, it says world government peacekeepers. None of them say U.S. anymore. And they all have hateful looks on their faces.
Yeah. This is a real peacekeeper here. He's going to
blow. Can somebody run out, since we mentioned that, and, like, grab those off the table by broadcast studio? Yeah, yeah. That's great. Man, I tell you, time is just boiling past us here. Continue with other points you had on your mind. But I want to get into the shooting now and you know, how that ties into mind control.
Okay, well, they take these little children, and at 18 months is where they split the mind. They create MPD, which is now in the DSM-4 and later. They've started calling it DID, dissociative identity disorder. The mind splits. It's a natural function. If you look at cattle out in a field during a blizzard, they'll have their rear ends towards the storm, and they'll be sitting there with a dissociative look, you know. Like that. It's a natural ability of the brain, but they manipulate the abilities of the brain and shatter the mind through the trauma, and only their bloodlines really had the DNA and the ability to create MPD when they traumatized. But since they've been working at traumatizing all of us in general, I mean, you turn on the evening news and they tell you good evening, and then they proceed to tell you all the reasons why it's not a good evening, you know. Well, there's a reason why they're traumatizing us. And like you were saying, when we're watching the television, we're getting into our alpha state. There are reasons why they're getting us into those states of mind. And those are the states of mind that they use for the programming. And they also have drugs. They use electroshock. They use drugs. They use deception, they use films that are coming out of Hollywood, and they've got certain very important themes that I wanted to share with the audience, because if they do happen to read this material, they're going to start getting all of the little details that they can see all around them. But just two real simple programming scripts that they use a lot is Alice in Wonderland and Wizard of Oz. I've been sitting in churches listening to Bible-based sermons, and then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, the minister's talking about the Wizard of Oz, saying something from the Wizard of Oz. That's totally incongruous to his whole train of thought. He just slips it in. What's that all about? It's this programming. Those are programming scripts.
And the general public is having their minds prepared with an overall basic programming to get into the deeper programming. And a lot of people that are actually engaged in more programming, they're so programmed, they're just repeaters repeating as well. And generally, the public is being moved more and more into this unconscious state.
Right, right. That's part of the externalization of the hierarchy, too. They're pulling the general public towards their total mind control that they used to be doing just with their members. World War II was used to take the trauma to a scientific level. One of the major reasons why they had the concentration camps was Mengele had to work out the very detailed specifics on how much trauma you could give to a person of a specific weight, a sex.
And that was admitted. That's why they brought him and Klaus Barbie and others that David Dewhurst, running for Senate here in Austin, worked with. He's very proud of that. Literally, Klaus Barbie down in South America. They brought him over here and then implemented all that here because they had important data.
Right. And so So Mengele learned these. He put it on a scientific basis. So in the 1950s, they were perfecting this total mind control on a scientific basis with individuals. In the 1960s, you'll start seeing cults like the Jim Jones cult and other cults that were being used by them using their front organizations like the CIA. They started using those smaller cults to perfect using mind control with small groups. And then from the 60s into the 70s, they started working towards controlling entire nations. So they just kept progressing to larger groups with more sophisticated mind control.
And that's why you talk to somebody about the New World Order, they get a glazed look. They've been pre-programmed.
Yeah.
But something's happening. People are either really waking up and breaking the programming, because I've made the point, we're actually doing an article for an upcoming magazine I'm going to put out, titled, you know, We Are Mind Control. This culture is mind control. The U.S. exports mind control. And where are we in the battle? Because I see huge awakenings happening. I see the globalists as being pretty freaked out right now. So they're accelerating their program that was behind and trying to hurry up and flip things upside down right now in an attempt to just make us become, you know, basically catatonic or go into a learned helplessness phase. But I don't see that working very well for them. I mean, they staged that shooting, Fritz, and I want you to talk about that. I mean, if you agree with me, it has the telltale signs. And the poll numbers went up for guns. And they're really freaking out that their public trauma-based mind control freak-out videos aren't working anymore. People know not to trust these people.
Well, that's great. And the analogy to that is if you're in a dark room and you light a little match, that little match's light lights up the entire room. So efforts by little people like myself and you go a long ways. And there's several things that have given the common person tremendous power, and that's the internet, and that's the photocopy machine. And so we're able to disseminate information outside of the controlled media.
And Cass Sunstein at the White House admits that that's happening. So he says flood the alternative media with disinfo and infighting.
Exactly. That's what they're trying to do, too. That's why I encourage people not to get into the infighting. People are always trying to, sending me emails, trying to get me to infight with other people. Like, you know, they would like me to be against you and so forth. And that's counterproductive.
Well, that's always a telltale sign.
Let's see. Where else shall
I? We were getting into the shooting. I mean, itself, break down the shooting in Colorado.
Well, James is clearly dissociative, and that's a real sign of mind control.
Yeah, he can't even talk. At the last three court appearances, he's out of his mind. They go, oh, we're not going to discuss his Air Force psychiatrist that was the head of psychiatry at one of the biggest bases in the U.S., and then just moved to be his little helper. We're not going to discuss any of that. And yeah, he's there drooling in the meetings. Clearly, textbook.
Right.
Out of his mind.
Totally
mind wiped. Can't even talk. But that's okay. Because he did it because we say so.
Right. And then another clue is his family and things about him that are red flags. One of the things that they do with the mind control is they have learned how to, like, for instance, do brainstem scarring. It's working off of the same principle as those of us who work out in the gym. We tear our muscles down and the body rebuilds it stronger. Well, for the little child, they scar the brainstem and the body rebuilds it so that the person gets a photographic memory, which is similar to eidetic memory. The person, they have their little methods for trying to enhance the intelligence of these people. You look at his father was very intelligent, and his father was associated with the types of things that are connected to this mind control, you know, like DARPA. And
then his son's in a DARPA program, DARPA funded with a special helper.
Right. So these are red flags. And fortunately, a lot of people are now asking the right kind of questions. They're just not sitting there and taking the official explanation. But I would warn anybody who was an eyewitness to this shooting, who saw something out of the ordinary, just to be very cautious about who you tell it to. Because just like in the Kennedy assassination and 9/11, witnesses start disappearing.
Well, take Sirhan Sirhan. The LAPD, the coroner, said he didn't shoot him. Witnesses said his arm was held down. The guy behind him shot him, caliber, different caliber. Turned out the CIA was there that day. Sirhan Sirhan was drugged. I mean, that's come out now.
Yeah, he was definitely an example of how mind control is used to create an assassin.
But a lot of times I've found they just have some drugged up guy, doesn't know who they are. Mm-hmm. They just roll out who takes the fall.
Right.
You've got other, and the people were saying smoke bombs from both sides. They thought there were multiple men, looked like, you know, police right. type outfits. Yeah.
Right. Exactly. So we have witnesses saying that there were other people involved. He was watching for someone. And so those are clues that we're not getting the full story.
I also saw the New York commissioner come out 2 days after and say, there's a man, red hair. Yes. Yes, he's after Batman. And I saw the transcript on CBS News. I didn't think it was real. I thought it was some kind of joke. It was because they were like blurring Batman, in Gotham City with this. And I went and found the video. And sure enough, you can just see it's all a big, it's like a holiday to them. They're blurring Batman and the Joker with all of this. And it's like, well, don't worry, we'll be at theaters looking for the Joker. And then in the film, the cops are the heroes. I mean, I tell you, this is a new level.
At the Rocky Vista University at the same time, same general time period that this happened, they were having a mock event to train. You were probably aware of that. So, like you were saying earlier, they'll show these things ahead of time. Okay, this is what we're going to do, and we can,
7/7, they had drills, the exact same train and bus, hit at the exact same time, exact same location, and then they went on TV and said, it's very interesting, Peter Powers, advisor consultant, said, we were running a drill of the exact same targets, exact same location, exact same time. It's extraordinary.
So they always like to tell us.
Yeah,
we've seen this before. Again, we're following a script.
And that follows the psychology of psychopaths. And they'll start calling the cops, sending them letters. I'm going to strike again. You can't stop me. Who's the guy in the Midwest who turned out to be like a government official who was killing everybody?
Oh, you mean Bundy?
No, there was another guy a few years ago. I forget the name of it. He was a government official. He was killing a bunch of people. And he would taunt the police.
No, the point is
they just do this over and over again.
Right. Right, so you start seeing these patterns, and that's what I want people to start becoming aware of, is seeing these patterns, seeing the clues. If they happen to get this information that I have on the mind control, they're going to, once they learn how it operates, what the programming scripts are, and how these people act, if you're around somebody and they can't remember their childhood and they have inconsistent behavior, like maybe they're a Christian, but one in the next hour they're cussing.
That would mean I'm under mind control then.
No, you're not that inconsistent.
If I hit my finger with a hammer, you're going to hear some pretty bad stuff.
you're gonna start seeing this all around you. And a lot of people have approached me or called me and thanked me for this information on the mind control because it explained what they had been around their entire life or probably now. I'm having about two a week that people that have been subjected to this kind of mind control contacting me begging for help. Unfortunately, I'm not in a position to help because these kind of people need a safe place. I don't have a safe place to offer anyone.
Expanding on that, how do you differentiate? Because, I know there's a lot of these real programs. There's a lot of secret testing that goes on. But then there's also people from the chemicals and things. Most schizophrenia they found is chemical-based. But there are a lot of people who are schizophrenic, and they're imagining these things. These are real programs. They've come out in Congress. Incredible, giant programs like Ewing Cameron's, thousands of children grabbed, you name it. That's all admitted, so we know this is happening. Psychiatry itself is a predatory system more and more, where the Sergeant Bales, who supposedly killed 19 people in Afghanistan, had part of his foot blown off. They put him on Prozac. He doesn't want to go back. They send him out. you know, who knows what that really was, where he kills them and burns the children and all this. These drugs do that. I mean, they put you in this very suggestible place where you can have these psychotic breaks. But how do you differentiate who is genuinely mentally ill versus someone who's been programmed? Because, I mean, the programming, I've seen what's been declassified. It's the Air Force, DARPA, they do this to their own kids.
Right.
And really, it's just perverts that go to the next level of mind control. You know, Sandusky was doing mind control type stuff.
Unfortunately, the very first thing that they do to these children is to create a psychotic break. So what we've had going on for thousands of years is insanity breeding insanity.
And sure, the elite's interbred that creates insanity. They've had syphilitic brain infections.
Well,
so the elite themselves are insane.
Yeah, and then their programming makes them insane.
So and then they want to make us like them. They're changing the environment to an inbred syphilitic brain.
So
have you looked into that?
No, not really. But talk about that. When you mean they're creating a syphilitic...
Well, I mean, you've got all this inbreeding that in any mammal species creates aggression, paranoia, insanity. Mm-hmm. You know, I mean, the royalty. You know, most of the Egyptian dynasties were living about 14 years old and couldn't walk because they were inbreed. You know, they were God.
Right.
The globalists interbred again through royalty. They interbred again in a Darwin study, you know, with five families. It created just monsters. So the elites are hyper-predatory, which allows them to do these bad things. They see that as survival of the fittest, social Darwinism. No, really, they're a cancer malfunctioning.
Right.
But then if you add compounded syphilis throughout every major ancient civilization right through to today, the elites were all having tons of sex, didn't understand that they had the brain infections, microscopic worms eating their brain. You know, Jack the Ripper was the prince out hacking people up because he was insane. So I'm saying inbreeding and then chronic syphilis... across the board, that is from my own sociology, anthropology research, that is what constructed, because every ancient society had syphilitic inbred leaders, so that's why they all ended up like Nero, dressing up as a werewolf at public parties, having a child chained up that he'd ripped the throat out of with blood spraying all over him. I mean, that really went on. That was, he was quite, he had public parties where he did that. So my point is, that's what inbred syphilitic brains do. So this manifestation is my... inbred syphilitic brain, not even so much theory, but equation.
And then what takes it to a new level is when you're turning that person into a multiple personality, all of the junk, all of the satanic stuff, it can be hidden back in the back. And what they do is they create a good front. And so you look at the man... Huntington Russell, who created the Skull and Bone Society, highly respected. They have excellent fronts. They have the power to give these people the best education, to give them awards, blah, blah, blah. And they build them up, and that the front that the public sees is impeccable. It looks really good. But if you were to live with that person, you would start to find out that there's another side to them. But as far as the public's image, a lot of these people have impeccable public images. I'm just telling the audience that there's more to these people than meets the eye.
And we're looking at one of the Rothschilds right there, who always is out wearing goat's heads around her neck. Nice person.
There we go.
I forget which Rothschild. That's the one who lives out in California. What's her name? Oh, little devil around her neck. John Bound. Yeah, that's Philippine Rothschild.
Yeah, Baroness. Yeah.
Baroness.
Yeah.
Oh, she looks nice.
Yeah, I was, as a tourist, I was at their winery, their mansion, and the people that worked there definitely appeared to me like they were under this total mind control. They were robotic.
Kind of Renfield types. All right, Fritz, other points you'd like to make, other points, directions you'd like to go in that I haven't raised.
Wow. I guess as normal, I try to give people hope, encourage them. I mean, I don't have all the answers. You don't have all the answers. But what concerns me is people hear this kind of information from you and I, and they shut down. It's too much for them. And yet, I would just say, look, when you go and play a basketball game, you don't shut your eyes and put your hands over your ears. When you're playing a game against your opponent, you're going in with all your senses alert. We're in a war. People may not like to acknowledge that, but we're in a war. And they need, like you're saying, InfoWars, but it's a war that's even more of a struggle. We're fighting for the survival of the human race. We're fighting for the children. We're fighting for all of these things. And people need to come out of their denial. And they need, and how, what will cause them to want to listen to this? They have to realize that there is hope. I mean, look at me. Look at what happened to me, and I'm still here. You know, I just want to encourage people to move forward in a positive direction and not cower down.
They're only able to do what they do because, as you were saying, we're not conscious. People think it's an attribute to not be involved and be uninformed. No, the people perish for lack of knowledge.
Exactly. Exactly. So start becoming informed. See all this stuff around you. And people are standing up at all levels. It may be, it may mean just going to the PTA meeting, you know, but do your part. And all of us, if we take care of our own backyard, are going to have the solution. As a group, we will have the solution.
I think a big part,
we don't have the solution.
I think a big part of the solution is recognizing, you can debate how deep it goes, how evil they are, but the admissions of, they know DU will kill troops, but they authorized it 20 years ago for use, or 22 years ago. The UN has been caught kidnapping kids by the hundreds of thousands a decade, you know, all over the world. This is not debatable. All these elites admit they're into the occult. They're doing all sorts of horrible things. They are putting cancer viruses in the vaccines. They know fluoride's brain damaging us. Harvard just came out and reviewed over 12 studies and said, yeah, it is brain damaging people. But let's continue. I mean, it's like so much of it now is just in our face. The bankers have now been announcing all over the news that they've conquered the U.S., that it's a world government by the bankers. I mean, they're really flaunting it. And I see them doing that because they tried to keep this hidden. They wanted to have revelation of the method slowly. But all the evidence I see is that they're not all-powerful. They're in trouble. That's and right. Even a lot of their own minions and people that aren't completely programmed are coming out of it. And we're even seeing rebellions within the power structure itself.
Right. Evil contains the seed of its own destruction. And also, you can see that God has kind of a subtle humor. Because for hundreds of years, they had targeted the date 2000 is when Lucifer was to be enthroned. And 2000 came and he didn't get enthroned at that.
And they didn't cap the pyramid. They were going to put a cap on it. They had these weird Illuminati rituals on PBS on, you know, the year 2000 that wasn't the new millennium, but it was their date. I mean, that was so incredible. And they said, we're not done. And I saw some French rock band in English going, come Lucifer, on television.
Exactly. So their plans didn't come to fruition like they, and for me, that was like God subtly giving them a hint, hey, you are not God Almighty, and your plans can go astray, and giving them a second chance to think about what's really going on, the bigger picture. And so just be encouraged that things are under control, God's still on his throne. And, you know, as the song says, we serve a mighty God, and there is power to do good. There is power to do what's right. And that's where real freedom comes from, is when we step out and do what's right.
That's right. You don't know how much power good's got until you step forward. Since you mentioned these,
yes, let's show the
you go to the toy store now. It's hard to find something where it's the U.S. military. World Peacekeeper, since you mentioned that, we'll show people maybe a close shot of that. And my children actually got this out of the exhibit area and took one of the men out. But look, they all have these ugly, here we'll lay them all right here and then get document cam shots up here. And let me sit. Thank you. Good job. Look at the ugly looks on their faces, police and military heroes set, and they all look angry. And but you know what? They're world heroes, though. Look at the face right there. He's like, "Ugh." That's like the TSA, "I won't stick my hands down your pants." Ugh. Yeah. Look at this guy. They're all like, I mean, look, they all make him look evil and crazy.
Yeah.
I mean, look at this guy. He's got like a, you know, one of the guys has got a face like this. I'm the good guy. He's like, we're the good guys, world peacekeepers. Here, show him that one right there. The world peacekeeper. Oh, look at him. Only the UN will have the guns. In closing, what about churches? What about what's going on? I mean, because I try to go to churches, Baptist, you name it, and they'll even have a good sermon. The people are, you know, have a good, you know, Christian vibe. They're nice families. But then the whole thing breaks into do what government says, worship the government, which is coming down from their seminary, coming down from the national level. People should know this is not, you know, a Christian doctrine. And so people get turned away from Christ because they see these counterfeits. But then the counterfeits are so good, a lot of the preachers even believe what they're saying.
Yeah. In an earlier book, my Be Wise as Serpents book, I documented who started a lot of these denominations and who's controlling them and who's controlling Christian education. And it's shocking. A large share of these denominations were created by Freemasons, are controlled by Freemasons, are Skull and Boners and Freemasons are running Christian higher education. I was sending my son to a Christian school, and in 1990, I went to pick him up at school, and something was wrong. I started asking questions and discovered that the Christian teacher was having the students spy on their parents and write diaries secretly every day. The parents were not informed of
that. Oh, that's done nationwide under law enforcement grants, yeah.
Yeah, and I asked her, who told you to do this? And she said, well, I was trained in the university at Mammoth, the teacher's college there, to do this. So our Christian teachers are having to go to the secular world to get certified, and they're being trained to do this kind of
thing. Oh, no. They have grants where you do it on a computer now, and the feds are in it, and you write about mommy and daddy. I mean, it's just now they're inoculating children without authorization in California and other areas. I mean, they really are monsters.
Exactly. So they always create boogeyman for us to think that the enemy's out there. Look out here, they're going to distract us. That's part of magic. You know, when you're doing a magic trick, what you're really doing is over here, but you wave your hand over here to distract the people. So watch out. They're always going to give us a boogeyman, but that's not the real boogeyman.
And they think we're so dumb, they're now in the London Guardian going, Al-Qaeda is really helping. No, I'm not kidding. There was an article today. In fact, I have it right here. I'll dig it out. They saying, you know what? Al-Qaeda's pretty darn good. You know, these are nice people.
And people just go lock, stock. They just walk along with it. You know, one day somebody's our enemy. The next day they're our friend. And people have shut off their critical thinking. They need to start taking responsibility for their own lives and start thinking for themselves.
All right. If it's the last article in the stack, I'm going to be amazed here. Guys, for some reason, it's not in here. It's linked on InfoWars and Drudge. Just type in Al-Qaeda winning the fight in Syria. Click news. It's something like Al-Qaeda winning the fight in Syria. Oh, here it is. Look, it's the one that I had right there. Look at that. Here, show folks a document came of that. Al-Qaeda turns the tide for rebels in battle. Oh, and it's like their incredible discipline and stylishness is helping. Well, hey, you know, give your rights up. We got to stick our hands down your pants. Look at TSA. I mean, is that not pedophile training the kids that they can be touched by people?
Right. And I've noticed how they've made things that were socially unacceptable before, like tattoos, now universally not only acceptable, but you have old ladies, you know, wanting to get tattoos. The next thing I'm wondering that they're going to somehow get us to accept is pedophilia. And if they could get us to accept some of the things that we've accepted in my lifetime, I have no doubt that people will go along.
Oh, no, in the NDAA, it says the troops can have their own animals on base. I'm not joking. Guys, type in NDAA legalizes bestiality on base. And it, you know, pigs, you name it. It's a new thing, yeah. And again, we're weird because we don't find a pig attractive.
Well.
No, no, we're the bad people now.
Yeah, yeah. We're not moving along in the direction that they want us to.
I ask you this question all the time. Where does it lead? I mean, I know where in their own documents, scientifically, they say once the control grid's in place, they'll release more and more hardcore bioweapons that they always claim they're fighting. And then they'll just finally, they want to kill 99%. They tell their minions 80%, you know, 90%. But, you know, in their deeper textbooks, I mean, I've had them write me and go, how dare you talk bad about Professor Pionk at UT? He only wants to kill 90%. Yeah. All humans should be killed. And you look up the doctor, just, you know, one of his graduate students years ago, and they're like in a bioweapon laboratory. Smiling, they'll show you. Because it's like that raw power in these demon minions. They're just like, we will kill everyone. When Dr. Pianca, just one case, he got national attention, like one of the heads over at UT down the street, University of Texas. He was at the Texas Academy of Sciences, got an award, he gets them all over the world. And he projected red skulls on the wall. This is in the news. And he said, you know, soon 90% will die. You know, I'm not happy my family has to die, but it's for the earth. Soon the airborne will come. Oh, come, you know. And it was a standing ovation with tears with the scientist. And it's just like this, we're going to murder. Oh, I mean, it's just like, oh, death. It's like this power thing. They just go, oh, death. Oh. I mean, they just, and like a normal person just wants life. It's like, ugh, I don't like that too much. I mean, what is that?
Yeah, and I've witnessed some of these people referring to the rest of us as useless eaters, not even realizing that, really, what are they contributing? They're parasites.
And they don't even care. Pianca says, I will be killed by them. But, you know, it needs to happen. So he at least understands that. But, I mean, what is a standing ovation about killing Earth and killing the, you know, killing the humans? And everyone's just like, I mean, it was reported in the news, three-minute standing ovation, either with tears. Just like, kill us. I mean, what is that?
It's insanity. It's a demonic, satanic agenda where the human race is hated. And you see that.
So they're basically being influenced by.
Yeah, exactly. That's why I.
What do you think about what David Icke says?
Well, I don't go there. I'll let him do his thing, and I prefer to stay with things that are 3D, that are provable and factual.
But we are on a planet hurtling through space. The sky's the limit. I mean, who knows?
Who knows? He believes in what he's putting out. I think he's sincere. I haven't seen the proof of what he's saying, so I have backed off from.
Well, I mean, exactly. They admit there's a brainwashing camp within Camp X-Ray. They just admit it, where they torture people, and then those guys go out into the news, suicide bombers.
Yeah.
It's like, oh, the graduates from there.
Right.
And they admitted in stuff that they, I can't even say the stuff they do on air. They dress up like devils. They put the guys on hallucinogens. They have prostitutes come in and rape the men while putting blood all over them. I mean, this was in the news. Abu Ghraib, they admitted that they ordered the troops and they hired jail guards that have been, you know, kicked out in the U.S. to rape the children, but with battery acid. And I mean, whenever I say this, people go look it up. Just type in Abu Ghraib Army Report and you get it. And it's in there, raping kids, battery acid. You know, I can't even mention. Yeah. I mean, it's like, what? You're like, really? And but then Jack Bauer sometimes tortures a kid to get the dad to talk, but it saves the L.A. from the nuke. So see, on 24, it's saving people. So, I mean, like they're literally, and for the average person that watches these shows, they're like rooting for the good guys who are now the bad guys.
Exactly.
They're like, but it's only Al Qaeda's kids we torture. But Al Qaeda was never even there. Al Qaeda works for you.
Right.
I mean, it's all just like a puppet they bring out and they go, here's the Al Qaeda man, and we go, ooh, Al Qaeda.
Exactly.
What do you make of that?
Yeah, well, you're right on track. I've sometimes said buzzwords and watch people robotically start spouting off a bunch of words. You know, they've been preconditioned to, you know, neuro-linguistic programming. They've been conditioned that this word means this. You know, they're not even thinking. You know, Osama bin Laden, then they think this. Al-Qaeda, they think this. You know, it's just... You can see it. You can see that they're not even, they're just regurgitating.
And even if you don't call it mind control, but, you know, calling humans social animals as the globalists do, I hear these talk show hosts that I know personally locally who know full well what's going on, but they'll sit there and just play kind of whatever the establishment's saying. They'll just repeat it, and that's what a winner does. A winner just repeats, and so you just become, but no, they're not winners.
Right, exactly. Well, and I've had some people tell me that they are aware of the Illuminati and this this world agenda and so forth, but they want to be on the winning side, and they think that that side's going to, the other side's going to be the winning side.
But that's, again, that's not winning.
No, it isn't. No, it isn't.
Fritz Springmeier, this has been a truly intriguing visit. Did you enjoy seeing your father?
Yes, very much so.
How was he doing?
Well, you know, I like to tell people don't get old. He's going through some of the normal stages of getting old. He's not as mobile as he used to be, but overall, he's still in fairly good shape.
And weren't you telling me your dad was instrumental in part of your awakening, right? I forget the whole story.
No, but other relatives of mine were. His parents were, but my father wasn't.
What did your dad do? It was some story you told me. I forget.
My father wanted to help the world by going to third world countries and developing their agriculture, help the world become self-sufficient. So he had his own way of saving the world, his own goals. He's always believed that you should leave the world a better place than what you found it.
That's civilization. That's humanity.
Yeah.
Who was the other family that helped wake you up?
Well, my grandparents were local leaders in the ag movement. And, in fact, my grandmother was on television in Topeka advocating for the farmers. And the farmers during the Carter administration were trying to understand what is going on, who's setting the prices for us, and why can't we make a living, and why is everything going against us? And then they started tracking down who are the decision makers, the string pullers. And that's when they discovered the Council of Foreign Relations, Trilateral Commission, and so forth. And so they were the banksters. So they helped me understand that level. But those are fronts for something even more sinister. So then I've just taken what they helped me learn and taken it to a higher level.
We can debate 20 families, 16, 13. How many super ruler families are there?
Well, they chose the number 13, but within those 13 bloodlines or tribes, there are five powerful families that are an inner circle again, you know, and so.
And then the other families, they've got branches into other families.
Yes, yes, so. Right. So,
where would the Bushes be? They're like a minion family, right? Sometimes they have generational minionships.
Yeah, they would not be in the well, they do have some blood from royalty. So I'm not sure exactly which bloodline they would classify themselves under. They might be classified with that holy bloodline, the royal bloodline that all the aristocrats in Europe have, and if that's the case, if they're identified in the Illuminati with that, they would be actually within that inner circle of.
Let's close on this. I haven't reread Bloodlines of Illuminati in a few years, but I mean, I know I can flip it open here, actually, the bibliography, where you talk about they're really a Transylvanian bloodline. They're not even a German bloodline. The Saxe-Coburg-Gotha is known as the House of Windsor. That's their brand name. How did you discover they were really Transylvanians and that they, you know, were hanging out there? Because now that's mainstream news.
I just was doing genealogy work because the people that I worked with in the Illuminati were talking about how the British royal family was Illuminati, and how important it had been when the Illuminati members, when Princess Di had her wedding with Charles, and so I was trying to understand these people better, you know, trying to track down just who are these people, and then of course you have a genealogy work in there where I show how 25 American presidents are closely related. I think that's significant. And some charts.
Well, it's like how Obama, it turns out, was related to Cheney and then Bush, and then they're all related to Kerry.
Yeah, exactly. We're
trying to find it here. Dracula, where is that? Would it be under Dracula?
There should be something indexed Dracula, yeah. And then, and some people don't believe that Dracula existed. They get upset when they open this book.
But Vlad the Impaler, that's on record.
Right. He was a historical figure, but some people who don't know history think that it was just a fiction of Hollywood.
Yeah. Well, it's amazing. I hope people get the book at InfoWarsShop.com. Support us, support you. Are you glad we got it back in print in a big way?
Yes. And I think a lot of your listeners are too.
Absolutely. Well, we should look at getting these in print in a you know, cover like this. We need to get those out there, because I read those as well, and it's certainly food for thought for everybody. Fritz Springmeier, thank you so much for spending time with us.
Thank you.
Well, that is an over-hour interview with Fritz Springmeier.